YouTube, what the crap's going on? Heir of Carthage here, and with the release of the Emperor Edition, it's time to definitely jump back in the multiplayer and get a feel for how things are going to be. I wanted to start off the first one by using the faction Armenia. I guess this will kind of be like a little mini faction focus on them. I'll show you the battle and then talk a little bit about their units afterwards. And I actually got to play two battles against this guy, so stick around until tomorrow and you'll get to see the second battle. This one was Armenia versus Lusitani, which to me feels like an advantage for Armenia, just because the Lusitani are pretty weak to missiles, and they're also weak to cav, both of which Armenia are good at, in my opinion. So I'm not sure it's a good matchup. My opponent originally picked Lusitani, and then I picked Armenia, not because I was trying to counterpick him, but because I wanted to be Armenia. I wouldn't have bothered me if he would have changed factions, but we'll see how it plays out. Just because I think they have an advantage doesn't mean that I'm going to win or something. So, my army is pretty straightforward. I've got 6 Persian hoplites just to hold up enemy swords, because I expect the Lusitani to have swordsmen. But of course, you never know. He could know his Armenia and bring spearmen. I've got 2 horse archers. I believe it's like 4... Yeah, so 4 Eastern archers. I didn't go with the elite Persian archers because Eastern archers have similar characteristics and are quite a bit cheaper, other than armor and attack. So the Eastern archers still give me a lot of missile power, just not any staying power if I get attacked by his cavalry. His cavalry offering is basically just Scutari cav, which is better, very much better in this patch, but absolutely no match for cataphracts. A lot of people, I've still seen complaints on the forums about shock cavalry. I don't know if it's true or not because I haven't gotten to do a whole lot of extensive testing in play. Cataphracts, though, usually are not complained about. They are pretty generally accepted to be good units in this patch, and I find them to be quite good against infantry and cavalry. However, I think there's some key ways to use them properly. So I'll show you my opponent's army when it becomes more in view. Right now we can see 3 Balearic Slingers and another Scutari Cav. I go ahead and start skirmishing with his Balearic Slingers. This is really not the type of skirmishing fight that his Balearic Slingers want to be in. His guys have very nice armor-piercing capability and can be quite useful against infantry, especially when you're getting flank shots, but they really don't fare too well against archers, especially if the archers can mass fire against them, so I always recommend mass your fire. But now, my Eastern archers do not have much armor or a whole lot of hit points, which means that they are going to be easy targets in return for the Balearic Slingers, so you can see that a couple of my Eastern Archer units copping it pretty hard here from his Balearic Slingers. But fortunately, by weight of numbers and the missile attack of my men being superior, it'll end up working out. So I'm going to go ahead and hit play here and just kind of show you how the rest of this is going to go down. So yeah, you can see I pushed his Balearic Slingers back, which is good. And he's going to start bringing infantry forward, and I really want to shoot his infantry here. He wants to take 3 Scutari Cav against my 2 Cataphracts. It's a fight that I'm willing to take, especially since I have a slightly downhill charge. And to show you this charge taking place. So, yeah, my Cataphracts are going to waylay the Scutari Cav off the charge, and then actually do pretty good in prolonged combat. I also have this Mercenary Cappadocian Cav nearby that I was kind of going to use to hold his spears up, but I accidentally got it caught here for a second. So his spears are going to come join this fight, which that's going to be a problem. But you can see how vulnerable the Lusitani are to archer fire. You can see my Eastern archers here just laying waste to his veteran shield warriors, which are otherwise pretty good units. They did take away headhunt from the veteran shield warriors whenever the Emperor Edition released, which is kind of disappointing. It's kind of a feature that they wouldn't have hurt them to keep. But at this, I mean, whatever way, it doesn't matter. It just means that you're going to have to understand them a little differently. Here I'm going to take my Cappadocian Cav and his Scutari Cav. That'll be a fight that I'm okay with as well. And you can see that his Scutari Cav over here just got crushed by my Cataphracts, even though the spears were nearby to support. I've been letting my horse archers fire at his spears, and here I'm even going to take a rear charge quickly into a bunch of his spearmen, which is going to hurt them pretty badly too. So you can see that their morale's getting torn up a little bit, and they're going to lose some men. And then that allows me to free my Cataphracts, and then this Persian hoplite allows me to just hold up his guerrilla warriors here. I went ahead and targeted his general with my archers, trying to get a few shots. Lusitani nobles are also vulnerable to archer fire, especially when their shield side is not facing, and then also took the opportunity to charge with my Cataphracts. Now this Cataphract charge was not what these Lusitani nobles want to take. You can see that I pretty much pretty quickly get, you know, 10, 12 men, plus the archers are firing, so his general goes down pretty hard and ends up wasting Headhunt and the raised banner there. And then the reason I pulled through here is because his Lusitani nobles are not braced. He's clicking attack orders, which means that I can knock them over, and my cataphracts can easily slip through without many losses. So that's why I do that. I don't normally want to pull through if you hit a braced unit, because your men will die hardcore. Here, getting a nice rear charge with some mercenary Cappadocians. And then over here, all I have to do is just protect my archers. My general, I forgot to mention, is in a noble spearman. And obviously my opponent's line was four veteran shield warriors, Lusitani nobles, two guerrillas, a couple of guerrilla spearmen, and then his Scutari cav that's actually come back from routing now after having been beaten. I've pretty much destroyed his Balearic slingers. He's trying to get after my cataphracts with his Lusitani nobles. Perfectly good idea, but I can stay ahead of them at this point. I can outrun them. And again, you can see the Persian hoplites, very cheap unit, able to hold up the veteran shield warriors for quite a while. I'm not going to kill many of them with my Persian hoplites, but again, it's the fact that it takes them a few minutes to punch through me that really works out. You can see my Cappadocian cav kind of slowly whittling down this veteran shield warrior as well. Melee cav does not kill near as quickly as it used to, but that penalty due to being attacked from behind does play in, and you can see it starts to make his men waver. He does get around my flank with the guerrilla warriors here, but at this point my flank can become a lot more fluid. I have units kind of in all kinds of positions, and really it seems like he keeps trying to trap my cataphracts, which is not a bad plan. The cataphracts have damaged him badly, but I keep trying to pull away in a direction where he doesn't have troops, and with my infantry in the way, his infantry aren't really going to be able to follow me. So at this point my cataphracts really can't be pinned down by him, because he's lost pretty much all of his cav. And then I've got a horse archer here and here. I actually forgot about both these guys for a little while. I'm going to bring them back in now, though. But yeah, now you can see that his infantry is still hung on my infantry. I bring in my general, who's a noble spearman, and drop the raised banner to give my men better defense for a short period, which means that I'll come and reinforce with even more Persian hoplites. So now his infantry can't really retreat because they'll get chased. My archers can continue to fire into his vulnerable infantry, and then my cataphracts can get lined up for some rear charges. And that's exactly what I'm doing, just getting my cavalry pulled around into good charging positions. But again, it doesn't hurt to let their men get nice and worn down. You can see his men are now winded and getting tired from running around the battlefield trying to catch my men or to get around my flank. And it makes a big difference in their fighting capability. Now, my cataphracts here are pretty exhausted too, because I used trample on them earlier. It's not always a good idea to use trample early on, but I was looking for a quick knockout on a Scutari cav, plus I was pretty outnumbered. Had that just been a one-on-one situation, I wouldn't have used trample, because I would want my cataphracts to stay fresh, because see how these guys are moving faster? Charge damage is actually directly, or I say directly related, it's at least partially related to speed. So when your unit's exhausted, not only do you get some penalties, but the speed penalties for your unit being exhausted actually play in as well. So your units are going to get less kills on a slow charge than they will on a fast charge, which is the main reason why charging uphill doesn't do you any good either, because you're not getting any speed boost. So this was a victory for me. I think it's a bit of a faction mismatch, just in my opinion. So kudos to my opponent for taking it. I don't think that it was the easiest way. I could be wrong. Maybe you all know some Lusitani builds that'd be serious trouble for Armenia. It was a Pyrrhic victory. He fought well. Again, I think that was a faction mismatch. My archers did a great job. My infantry did a great job, too, of holding for as long as I needed it to. And you can see that that one cataphract unit there, 224 kills. A lot of those probably were Balearic slingers. But then all of my cataphracts doing fairly well. Even the one that didn't get many kills didn't get a whole lot of its unit killed. Horse archers, I kind of forgot about them most of the time. One of my Cappadocian cav doing an excellent job there, too, mopping up a lot of kills. So kind of balanced killing for my army. His army, you can see his infantry was quite capable. I mean, one of them with 124 kills, 100 kills each on his guerrilla warriors, not bad. His cavalry got flattened, which was kind of what I expected from the standpoint of the Lusitani, just not really a faction that can match up against Armenia or any of the eastern factions for cav. They'll do okay against, like, Rome for cavalry. Scutari cav is pretty cost-effective, and they do have guerrilla spearmen, which can aid your cavalry quickly. But it's something that's not real easy for the Lusitani. Being vulnerable to missiles and not really having an easy time getting a cav advantage is going to hurt them, generally. But let's go look at the Armenia faction real quick. I'll show you the rest of their troops. So as a faction, I would say Armenia is going to be a Bactria with less options, kind of. Not exactly. I don't know. They're kind of a mix. Well, I guess you could also think of them as like a Parthia with no elephants and more infantry, maybe. I guess. I don't know. It's kind of hard to explain. I mean, they're an Eastern faction, clearly. They've got a hodgepodge of units from Eastern things. These noble spearmen are new. I'm not sure if we've seen these guys in any other faction up at this point. Not a particularly powerful unit in an infantry fight. They can hold their own, but they'd be pretty good against cavalry. And it's a good way to put your general in the place where he's probably going to be the most protected. Good armor, good defense. Not great, but good. Decent charge bonus. You can put them into a square formation. They don't have hoplite phalanx or anything like that. The other generals you can choose from are Ozzet Knights and Royal Cataphracts. Ozzet Knights, I'm not really sure. Honestly, I'm not really sure what role super heavy melee cav plays yet in this patch. I haven't gotten enough time to work with it. I haven't been able to use them successfully just yet. Not the super heavy kind, at least. There could be a role for them. If you think you know, put it in the comments. Again, I'm not saying there isn't. I just don't know what it is yet because I haven't played enough. Royal Cataphracts, definitely a powerful unit right here. Hugely powerful unit. Probably going to be the general of choice for most Armenian players. They've got Hillmen, Axemen, and a new unit here, the Kartli Axemen. These are some pretty brutal Axemen. They've got really nice melee attack, which means they'll score hits often. Their weapon damage is rather low, but it's got a decent amount of armor. Well, it's not even that impressive on armor piercing, actually. I would expect more from an Axeman. Huh. That's weird. I wonder what the armor piercing is on Roman infantry, just out of curiosity. Let's look at this Praetorian. Okay, well, it's twice what the Romans are. Never mind. Okay, so it's good armor piercing, comparatively speaking. Just different than what I was used to seeing in the past. So Eastern Spearmen, these guys actually probably going to be a little more useful now that all units last a little longer, but still not a good unit. Very low morale. Persian Hoplites, you saw them at use in that battle. Not going to win you an infantry fight, but they can hold people up and they can be useful against cavalry. Noble Spearmen, probably want to be careful how much of these guys you use. They could be helpful against cav, but as with all expensive spearmen, there's always that trade-off of are you actually going to be able to get your enemy's cavalry pinned where they can do the work? Because if not, they're just going to run away from you. You just be careful with expensive spears has been my experience. Eastern Archers, great unit for them to have. Cheap archer, it's effective. Elite Persian archers. These guys do have a spear when it comes into a melee fight, so they can help fend off probably light cavalry. I don't know that they'll be successful at it every time, but they'll be a little stronger. Their health is 50, and they don't have much armor, though. 15 armor, it's pretty low. So that's why these guys will actually die a little easier than Cretans, plus Cretans have a higher attack. So they're superior in a shooting fight. As our Syrian heavy archers are going to be superior in a shooting fight. These guys are just a little more sturdy in a melee. They also have access to Eastern Slingers. Not a bad unit if you're looking for some extra shooting power in an army. Noble Blood Cav, great cav unit, and that's their cheapest cav unit, which you can see that they have some excellent melee cavalry. These Mercenary Cappadocians, also an excellent unit. Definitely a powerful unit. It's kind of reminiscent of Bactrian Noble Horse in a way, though I think it has slightly less armor. So excellent unit there, and then Ozzet Knights, also a very powerful unit again, though. Not sure what their role is. These guys are going to be pretty darn good. It would make me hesitant to spend almost twice that much on a single unit. That's only marginally better, really. I mean, it's got quite a bit more health and melee defense, I guess, so it'll last longer to fight, but again, that's a questionable decision, in my opinion. So, Missile Cav, they've got access to Horse Skirmishers, Horse Archers, Armored Horse Archers, and Noble Horse Archers. We've seen these guys with Parthia before. And, yeah, that's pretty much it for the Armenians. I find them to be a good faction for just what I did here. Picking away at infantry factions, cataphract charges for their killing their cav or crushing their infantry. Just a good all-around Eastern cav faction. Don't have elephants, which means against heavier infantry factions like Rome, could have your work cut out for you, but I mean, honestly, Kartli Axemen are not great, but they're not bad. They can definitely help you against the Romans, or you could use the Persian Hoplites to hold while you hammer an anvil. Great skirmishing compared to the Romans. I'm just saying, you know, don't expect them to grind you out of a lot of infantry fights, typically. You're going to need to use your skirmishing and your cav to gain an advantage, for the most part, with Armenia. Anyway, hope you all enjoyed this. HeirofCarthage, signing off for now.